Good morning. How are you today? It is a beautiful day today, and did you notice the clocks might have been different when you woke up today? Did that happen in your house? Well, somebody remembered what time it was because you're here, right? What we're going to do is, for the people who forgot, we're going to greet them at noon when they come through the door today. When they come in at noon, we'll say, "Where have you been? We've been waiting for you." And they'll say, "When did you start church at 10 o'clock in the morning?" That's what they're going to say. Now, I'm just referring to, we have turned our clocks ahead, which means that spring is right there around the corner, right? Yeah, the spring season, or it already feels like spring. It's a little bit warmer. But that's not what I want to talk to you about. I'm going to start talking about Bible heroes. And if you were here last Sunday, do you remember the hero that we talked about briefly last Sunday? His name begins with the letter M, and it's not Mickey Mouse. Starts with the letter M. Do you remember the guy we talked about last Sunday? Your hand went up. Want to take a shot at it? Come on now. They're being shy, Miss Aaron. I don't know. They were that way last week too. Are you giving out shy pills to these kids or what? Starts with the letter M.
Michael Jordan.
Michael Jordan, yes. Bible hero, Michael Jordan. All right. Well, it's not Mickey Mouse. It's not Michael Jordan, but it starts with an M, the name of this guy. Ten Commandments. Does that ring a bell? Moses. There you go, Moses. Well, today we're going to talk about another hero and a little background information. When Jesus walked around, he selected 12 very close friends to walk with him. He would teach these guys, and he would demonstrate miracles in front of them, and he would set good examples for them. They're called the 12 disciples. 12 disciples. The word disciple means student, basically. So there were 12 students, and today I want to talk to you about one of them, a very special man whose name begins with the letter P. You want to guess who that might be? The name of the man who followed Jesus starts with the letter P. Peter, very good. That's who we're going to talk about. You could have said Philip. You could have said something like that. But you did bring up Peter, and that's what we're going to talk about. Peter is often considered the captain of all the disciples, of the 12. He was the leader. And when you read stories about Peter, it's interesting. Peter always jumped in when they needed help, or he always volunteered right away. And he had a lot of energy, a lot of enthusiasm. He was the first one to follow Jesus whenever Jesus needed something. In fact, he was so enthusiastic. There's a story about Peter where Peter was in a boat fishing, and he noticed Jesus on the shore, on the land. Well, Peter was so excited, he couldn't even wait for the boat to get to the land. He jumped out of the boat and started swimming until he got to the shore where Jesus was. That's how excited he was. And Peter is a very special man because after Jesus rose from the dead, Peter went around to a lot of different places proclaiming Jesus as the risen Lord. So he played a very big role in spreading the news of Jesus being alive after death. Now, I have in front of you an artist's drawing of what Peter may have looked like. You see this guy here? Now, we don't know exactly what Peter looked like because they didn't have cameras back then. But there is an artist's depiction of what Peter may have looked like. And this was later in life because he has a white beard like Pastor Jack now. He's older in this picture. And there's one more thing about Peter that I think you should know. There's a rumor. We don't know if this is true or not, but there's a rumor going around that when we get to heaven, Peter is going to be standing at the front door. I don't know if that's true. The Bible doesn't really say that. But over the years, we always thought about St. Peter standing at the gate of heaven, you know? So who knows? Maybe we'll see Peter when we get to heaven someday. Maybe he'll be at the front door to greet all the newcomers that come in. Was there a question? Did you have a question? Yeah. Am I Peter? No, but do you know anybody named Peter? You do. You know somebody named Peter, don't you? Yeah, as in your grandfather, huh? Anybody else know anybody named Peter? No? It's a nice name. It's a very popular Christian name. Yeah. Are there any Peters here today? Any Peters? No, I don't see any. body named Peter. Okay. Can we pray about this and thank God for his Captain Peter, the great disciple? Can we pray about it? Let's pray. Oh, Lord, we thank you for all the men and women who answered the call to serve you. And we especially today honor and lift up a man named Peter. He was so, so special to you and to others, and he served very, very well. And we thank you for Peter and all those who've gone after him to follow in your name. And we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. And there's one more thing I want to tell you about Peter before you run off. Peter made a few mistakes in his life. Did you ever make a mistake? Yeah, we all do. We all make mistakes, and it's okay, because you can say to God, I'm sorry for those mistakes, I'm sorry for what I did, and Jesus forgave Peter for the mistakes that he made along the way, but he ended up doing a lot more good than a few mistakes that he made. I just wanted you to know, he was a human being, he wasn't perfect, nobody is, but he was a great follower, okay? Got it? Miss Erin, we have a great Sunday school lesson planned, I'm sure, so follow Miss Erin. And have a wonderful, wonderful day. Once again, we welcome back Jennifer Foos to our keyboard. Jennifer?